Hello, and welcome to 5 Minutes of Postgres. My name is Lucas, and today we're going to talk about speeding up sort performance in Postgres 15. In this blog post by David Rowley, he talks about the improvements that were made to the Postgres 15 release in regards to sorting. This is work that was done by him and three other authors, Erwin, Thomas, and Heike. Why does sort performance matter? Sorting is not just happening order by queries, but sorts are also relevant for aggregate functions, for group by queries, union or distinct, or having a window function. But there's a lot of things where sorting matters, and Postgres will be faster in Postgres 15 thanks to these changes. There are four improvements in this post that we're going to go through today. The first improvement is on sorting a single column. The simplest example here is select call one from table ordered by call one. In previous Postgres versions, what Postgres will do is, even in simple sorts like this, it will work with the whole row that was retrieved from the table. In Postgres 15, on the other hand, that is special case, and so single column sorts are significantly faster. This only applies to single columns, so if you have two columns, for example, then that keeps using the same row-based approach as before. This also applies to cases that do merge semi or anti-joins. The most typical case of this would be an exists clause. I'm sure you've written queries if you've done those before. The performance improvement here is actually quite impressive. If you're sorting 10,000 integer values and sorting a single column, in Postgres 14, that takes 1.8 milliseconds, and in Postgres 15, it takes 1.49 milliseconds. So there's about a 26% improvement. The second change that was made is reducing memory consumption by using a different memory allocator. Postgres has two main memory allocators that are relevant here. The first is the aset memory allocator. When aset ends up making a memory allocation, it allocates that in the power of two. It helps avoid a lot of small allocations, which can be expensive. The other aspect here is that when memory is freed, Postgres is able to reuse that memory better with the aset allocator. The most important realization here was that typically Postgres doesn't actually need to free memory for records when sorting, because it knows how big the sort is, it loads all the data, it does the sort, and then at the end, when a sort is complete, it frees the data. So that's a bad fit for the default allocator. The other allocator is the generation allocator in Postgres. It doesn't have some of the overhead of the aset allocator, and it doesn't have that same power of two behavior. It shows between a 3% and a 44% improvement. But this doesn't apply for what's called a bounded sort. A bounded sort is when you have an order by and a limit clause. What's special about those type of sorts is that Postgres actually does free memory after it got enough data, after the limit is reached. Because of that, it's actually better to use the aset allocator. The third improvement is new specialized sort routines for common data types. Postgres has customizable data types. You can create your own data types, write some C code. Postgres is very flexible in that regard. That flexibility has a downside. When Postgres does a sort, it has to call into a data type specific function to do comparisons. As part of its quicksort algorithm, it has to do a comparison and say, is this larger, is this smaller, is this the same? David ran the numbers here. If you're sorting 10,000 records, that comparison function has to be called about 132,000 times. If you're sorting 1 million records, it has to be called about 20 million times. Obviously, there's a lot of function calls here. C compilers can inline things, but depending on the level of indirection, that inlining doesn't always happen. The change here is that there are new special functions for built-in data types that speed up the function call by inlining things. These functions have been added for integer types, for timestamps, and also if you're using a text type with a C location, that gives a nice consistent improvement between 4 to 6%. You don't need to do any extra work if you use the standard data types, then this improves the performance. Last but not least, there was also an improvement if you sort spills to disk a lot. This improvement here replaces the algorithm that's used for splitting up sorts onto disk when they exceed the workmem. Workmem controls at which point a sort is on disk versus in memory. The main benefit of this change is that it uses less I/O for doing the sort. For example, if you have a 4 megabyte workmem and you're sorting a 10 gigabyte table, on Postgres 14, it took 60 seconds. On Postgres 15, it only takes 43 seconds. So quite impressive improvements here. If you want to try out Postgres 15, you can try out the beta 1 today. The other thing I want to mention here is that if you're interested in learning more about new Postgres features or what the Postgres community is working on, Currently, this is end of May 2022, PGCon is happening. PGCon is the main Postgres hacker conference that happens once a year, typically in Ottawa, but this year again, it's online. Now is a great time to listen in and learn more about how Postgres works internally. Thank you so much for listening. This was 5 Minutes of Postgres. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to hear about next week's episode, and talk to you next week.